gone through what is the waveguide, what will happen if I close two ends of this particular waveguide with the shorting plate? Suppose this is a rectangular waveguide. Initially, I'm going to take an example of rectangular waveguide. I have this kind of a structure in the rectangular waveguide. What will happen if I close both the ends of this particular rectangular waveguide with the shorting plates? Now, this is nothing but this particular end is also closed. Ye aapne close kar diya. Ye wala end bhi yahan pe aapne close kar diya. So what will happen if I am putting a shorting plate, or when one end of the waveguide is terminated in a shorting plate? So you are keeping, like, just mentioning the dimensions here. This is the A, this will be the B, and if you're putting here a shorting plate, this particular dimension will be called as the T. So when such kind of structure will be there, there will be the waves which are inside your waveguide will be moved to and fro. Aapka kya ho jayega? Your waves will go from this side, and they will, as you have terminated it with shorting plate, your load or your is not terminated with a ZL or load is equal to Z0, but your ZL is equal to zero here. Okay? Zero ohms. So here the whatever comes from this side will not be delivered to the load, but they will reflect back. When the reflections will happen, when there is no match termination. So now here you are having a hollow space, okay? So then the hollow space so form can support a signal which bounces back and forth between two shorting plates. Now what will happen because of this particular phenomena? यहाँ पे आपका bounce back हो रहा है to and fro. So because of this, the resonance will occur in this particular cavity, and such cavity is called as the resonator cavity, and this is the concept of the cavity resonator. Now to have this kind of a resonator, if I see the cross section of this cavity resonator, I have this kind of structure, I have cutted it, and I have inside it, I have standing waves, 1, 2 and a 3. There is a condition. Now this is lambda g by 2. This is lambda g by 2. So this will be the 3 lambda g by 2. The resonance will occur only in this condition. Okay? If this is minima and if this is the maxima, if this is minima, this is maxima. So resonance, to have a resonance, this is the very important condition, that your distance, this distance must be, so whatever you have written here, that d dimension d or something like that, so your distance must be multiple of lambda g by 2. So if I'm putting here lambda g by 2, which is nothing but the multiple of, say, I'll just put here, this 3 lambda g by 2. So instead of t, you can put any, so you just put p lambda g by 2. So that must be any integer over there. So the resonance occurs over there. So if we see the simple structure of your resonant circuit, this is the rectangular cavity resonator. If you are enclosing two ends with a shorting plate for circular waveguide, this particular structure will be called as the circular cavity resonator. And this resonators will simply work. Now you can say the microwave cavity resonator is akin to a tuned circuit. Now what kind of structure you find in the tuned circuit? You are having an inductor, you are having a capacitor over here, and the resonance will occur here at F0 is equal to 2π√LC. So the cavity resonator can resonate at only one particular frequency, just parallel, just as in a parallel. So if you talk about this kind of a structure, it resonates only for this one. In cavity resonator also you'll get this kind of a structure. So for and your d must be p lambda g by 2. If I put it in lambda g form, I can say this must be 2d by p. Okay? So for a given resonator, a mode a, b, m, n are constant. Aapka ye jo bhi a side hai constant hai, b constant hai, then MN are constant, then your lambda C is also fixed. Okay? And your lambda zero will also have a fixed value, because lambda zero is C by F0. And F will also have a constant value equal to F0, which is the resonant frequency of the cavity resonator. So I can say if A, B, M, N are constant, I can say lambda zero and lambda C are fixed here. Now we'll talk about what kind of a resonant frequency you will get for the rectangular cavity resonator, and what kind of the frequency you'll get for the circular cavity resonator. So the first expression will be expression for F0, that is resonant frequency in a rectangular cavity resonator. This is also based on the previous things which we have seen. So when I talk about the propagation constant, H square is nothing but the, this is H square is gamma square plus omega square mu epsilon, okay? Which is nothing but the A square plus B square, whereas we know that A is nothing but the M pi by A square and B is nothing but the N pi by B square. So if I solve this, I'll get omega square mu epsilon is equal to M pi by A square plus N pi by B square minus gamma square. Now to have a propagation, my gamma must be equal to J beta. Okay? As we know that gamma is equal to alpha plus J beta, whereas alpha is attenuation constant, beta is a phase constant. When gamma is equal to alpha, you don't have a propagation. When gamma is equal to J beta, there will be the propagation. What about the gamma square in this case? This will be the minus beta square. Okay? Because you are going to square J square and a beta square over here. So this value will be minus beta square. Now let us put all these values here in this equation. So while rewriting this equation, I'll get omega square mu epsilon is equal to M pi by A square plus N pi by B square plus, now that was a minus gamma square, now it will become a plus beta square. Okay? Now if a wave has to exist in the cavity resonator, what is the condition? There must have a phase change corresponding given wavelength, that is beta is 2 pi by lambda g. Okay? So you must have the phase change. You must have a beta component for the propagation. Okay? And we have seen previously that your d is equal to p lambda g by 2. So you can say your lambda g is nothing but the 2d by p. So if you put a lambda g here, 2d by p, this beta will become 2 pi divided by 2d by p. So I'll just put p here, 2 will get cancelled. So this will become p pi by d. So here I can say that my phase constant here must be p pi by d. Okay, so here you can say the condition for resonance is that your phase constant must be p pi. So this is the condition for resonance. So if you are having a condition for resonance, then I can write this p is nothing but the constant. You can put any value here like 1, 2, 3 up to infinite. And what about the d? D is nothing but the length of resonator. What is the condition for resonance? That beta must be p pi by d. Okay? So at f is equal to f0, omega will become 2 pi f0, which is nothing but the omega 0, because this is the resonant frequency. Now substituting the value of b, you can write here omega 0 square mu epsilon is nothing but the m pi by a square plus n pi by b square plus beta square, that is p pi by d square. So this mu epsilon I'll just put there, and I'll just rewrite this equation again. Omega 0 square 1 upon mu epsilon, and the rest of the things will be same as previous. M pi by a square, n pi by b square plus p pi by d square. Now I know that omega 0 is nothing but the 2 pi f0. So putting all that things here, I can get f0 is equal to 1 upon 2 pi mu epsilon. Then this will be m pi by a square plus n pi by b square plus p pi by d square raised to 1/2, that is square root. Now if I'm interested in the f0, I know that 1 upon mu epsilon is nothing but the velocity of light, c by 2 pi. I'll write here. So I can write, Now, if you are going to talk about the pi in each and every equation, this pi can be cancelled. So putting all the values, m by a square plus n by b square plus p by d square. And just take the square root of this particular equation, you will get the resonant frequency. So this formula will give you the resonant frequency for rectangular cavity resonator. C by 2 square root of m by a square plus n by b square plus p by d square. Now general mode of propagation in the cavity resonator are T, E, M, N, P or T, M, M, N, P. Okay? So for both T and TM, the resonant frequency is same in the rectangular cavity resonator. आपका TE mode है या TM mode है, दोनों केस में आपका resonant frequency will be same. So this is the expression for F0 in a rectangular cavity resonator. Now next one is nothing but the circular cavity resonator. So what will be the resonant frequency for the circular cavity resonator? So if I'm interested in the F0, I'll just put all the things which I have done in previous. So when I talk about the circular plates at both the shorting end or both the ends, I'm shorting that with the circular plates because your rectangle, your waveguide is a circular here. Okay? So you can say this is the radius and this is nothing but the length or height of the cylindrical waveguide. So here also your condition for resonance will be same as a previously seen. So beta must be p pi by d. So here, like a rectangular cavity resonator, you'll put here h square is equal to gamma square plus omega square mu epsilon, which is nothing but the h square nm. So further solving this equation will become, I will write again this equations, okay, which becomes, I need to consider yahan pe aapka p nm by a, that is the radius square. So putting all that things, omega square mu epsilon will become p nm divided by a square is a minus gamma square. So if you'll put all these values and if you take the condition for the propagation, for propagation gamma must be equal to j beta. So if you square this, this will become minus beta, so this will become plus beta square. Okay, so for wave propagation I must have gamma is equal to j beta, because here f becomes f0, omega becomes omega 0 and your beta becomes p pi by t. So putting all the values, you'll get omega 0 square mu p n m by a square plus p pi by d square. Okay, now just solving this equation further, I'll get F0 is equal to, sorry, this should be the epsilon here. Okay, so this value will be 1 upon 2 pi mu epsilon, the same way P n m by a square plus P pi by d square and the square root of this equation. So I can say this is nothing but the resonant frequency. So you can say this will be for, if you're saying for the TM mode, then similarly you can write for TE mode. So this will become F0 is equal to C by 2 pi. And then this will be P dash NM divided by A square plus P pi by D square and the square root of the whole term. So these are the resonant frequencies for rectangular as well as the circular waveguide. Next one is nothing but the application. For which purpose we are using this particular cavity resonator? So very popular application of this particular cavity resonator is nothing but the tuned circuit. The second, you're using it in the UHF tubes. You're using them into the klystron amplifiers. Whatever we have seen up till now, the resonant cavity is based on this particular principle. Then you're using it in the magnetrons. You're using them into the duplexer of radars. And the last application is nothing but the measurement of a frequency. High frequency measurement ke liye aap isko, which is used in the cavity wave meters. So these are the very popular applications of cavity resonator. Now let us solve some of the problems based on this cavity resonator. Theek hai? So the first problem here, calculate the lowest resonant frequency. You need to calculate lowest resonant frequency of a rectangular cavity resonator. So here the dimensions are given. A is equal to 2 centimeters, B is equal to 1 centimeter, and D is equal to 3 centimeter. And you are interested in what? You are interested in the lowest resonant frequency. So when you say the lowest resonant frequency, means you are saying the highest cutoff wavelength. Okay, so you can say this mode is nothing but the dominant mode. So the question is asked for the dominant mode. So what will be the dominant mode here? The dominant mode in this case will be TE101 mode. So you do remember this. So whereas M is equal to 1, N is equal to 0, and P is equal to 1. So straightforward, we'll put all the values in formula, which is nothing but the C by 2. So you can say M by A square plus N by B square plus P by D square, and the whole term square root. Just put the values over here. All the things are in the centimeter. So I'll just put velocity of light also in the centimeter. 3 into 10 raised to 10 centimeters divided by 2. M is 1, A is 2 centimeter square, N is 0, B is 1, this term will be 0 here, plus P is 1, and D is 3 centimeter square, and the whole term square root. While solving all these things, I'll get the F0 is a 9 gigahertz. So for this, the solution, the lowest resonant frequency is nothing but the 9 gigahertz. Now the next problem, we'll solve it for circular resonator. This is the problem for the rectangular resonator. And next problem, we'll talk about the circular resonator. So second problem, calculate the resonant frequency for circular resonator, whereas diameter is given. D is equal to 12.5 centimeter. The length is given 5 centimeter. I will not call it as the diameter. It will be twice of radius. So twice of A is given, 12.5. I'll call it as a D. And then what is given? Mode is given. So TM012 mode. Okay? So while solving, I'll just see what things are given and what things I need to calculate. So the first thing given is nothing but the they have given me diameter. So I need to calculate the radius here. So if I say my diameter is twice of A, which is 12.5 centimeter, the radius will be 6.25 centimeters, and D is given, that is 5 centimeters. Now here 0, 1, 2 mode. So I can say M is equal to 0, N is equal to 1, and P is equal to 2. We are having a straightforward formula which says F0 is equal to C by 2 pi P N M by A square plus P pi by B square ka square root. So what will be the P and M here? So if we see the P and M is nothing but the PE01, which is 2.405. ठीक है? So these are the standard values. So you just take this P and M, that is nothing but the P01, which is 2.405. That is for the dominant mode TM01. ठीक है? So if you put that 01 value over there, we can write F0 is equal to 3 into 10 raised to 10, as the things are in centimeter, 2 pi, 2.405 divided by 6.25 plus 2 pi, that is 3.14 divided by 5, square of each term and the square root of the whole term. So while solving this equation, you will get 6.27 gigahertz. So I can say for a circular cavity resonator, the resonant frequency for 0-1-2 mode is 6.27 gigahertz. Now the same problem will do for the circular cavity resonator. So calculate the resonant frequency of a circular cavity resonator. So calculate F0 for circular cavity resonator. Dimensions are given. A is equal to 3 centimeters, B is equal to 2 centimeters, and L is equal to 4 centimeters. When the mode, and the mode is given as a TE101 mode. So we'll write all the things in the solution. The first thing which we'll write is nothing but the, what is given there in that particular equation. The A is given. So A is equal to 3 centimeter, B is 2 centimeter, D is 4 centimeter, then M 1 and 0, and P is equal to 1. So just put all the values over there. So I can write F0 is equal to C by 2. Do it for the rectangular cavity resonator. So rectangular cavity resonator, we know that this value will become C by 2 M by A square plus N by B square plus P by D square, and the whole term ka square root. So your F0 is equal to 3 into 10 raised to 10 by 2 into 1 by 3 square plus, we know that n is equal to 0, so that term will vanish as it is 101 mode. It will be 1 by 4 square square root. So while solving this, I'll get 6.25 gigahertz. So if I'm doing it for the rectangular cavity resonator, I get the resonant frequency as a 6.25 gigahertz. So this is all about the cavity resonator.